It's been around the block a few times, and that's what I'll be reading from today. On the back, you might see other words, and those are just books that I was listing for something else. One final caveat before I begin. It has been a while since I've seen some of these movies, like a full calendar year, and I did not look them up before beginning this video, so if I'm a little fuzzy on details or don't remember actors' names, which I never do, I'm the single worst person at identifying actors. Count me out. Cannot do it. You know, just go easy on me. This dive bar is closing, so all the barflies, all the regulars have gathered to ring out the last night together and have a good old time. And it's really well done because you go through the course of the night with all of them. It starts at like say 5 or 6 or maybe even earlier in the day because some people are heavy regulars. And then as the night goes on, more and more people arrive to celebrate the bar and say goodbye to it and say goodbye to one another. All of the people in it feel like characters, like they're fascinating people, and they reveal different layers of themselves as the night goes on. I loved watching it because I watched it time last year when everything was still raging and shut down. I mean, like, raging and shut down, you understand? And so it was a really wonderful movie because it's wonderful anyway, but it also genuinely felt like I was a barfly, like I was just at a dive bar, people watching, which is one of my favorite things to do. So it was great for that reason as well. And like I said, all the people are fascinating. Now, a spoiler. Okay, so close your little ears. Cover your ears with your hands if you don't want to hear this. I'll go like this when I'm done, okay? So I recommended this movie to my friend. I told her she would love it because I knew that she would, and she did. And this is after I watched it, okay? I missed this point, which is that even though it's meant to be a documentary, it feels like a documentary, it's actually not. It's actually, I think it might still be unscripted, but basically it was shot in New Orleans with actors, and I think maybe it was improvised. Straight because I was recommending this movie to everyone and did not know that it was not in fact actually a documentary. That said, I don't think I would mention that fact when recommending it to people necessarily, but I would mention it after the fact. If we were talking about it together, I would be like, oh, but you know about this other facet of it, right? Anyway, so if she hadn't seen it, I never would have found that out. It's not that I wish I hadn't found that out, but I was just like, duh, like, how did I miss that? decided to find a partner for herself or a husband, and so she's kind of trying to date, and I think she thought when she moved there that there would be all these single men there. But there aren't. There are serial daters and like swingers and people who are kind of available to her, but not really any men who are available. Also has a very interesting story, and the documentary is beautifully shot. I think each of these people has found themselves in such a interesting predicament that is so particular to that stage of life, and is just exasperated further by the community in which they live, which is a lovely community, but is full of other really happy things harder. So it's very, very good. Okay, then let's see. This one is not a cheery movie, but it's one that I definitely want to mention. There is a plane, and I'm not really sure how much you can hear with this mic, so I'm just doing my best to try to decide when to cut. Anyway, this movie is very stiff, and there are very few safety nets to provide these kinds of services. Like, there are very few resources and structures in place to provide these resources to the general public in a fair and just and safe way. So it's a for-profit industry, basically. They're a for-profit field, and there's a lot of complications makes friends with this young girl whose father owns this store where he starts to work to try to earn a little bit of money, and she is not a good actor. So their scenes together are very unevenly matched. Like, he's phenomenal and she is quite bad. So that was the only thing about it, but it's an excellent movie, and yeah, you should watch it. It would be a nice pairing too with I'm no longer here. Would pair nicely with
weekend,
but it's an utter fiasco, an utter list is Bad Hair, which is about a woman in the, I want to say, late 80s, early 90s, working in Los Angeles at a music video TV channel, who wants to get promoted at work, but in order to do so, she needs to change her hair. She's a black woman, and she has a natural hairstyle. Comes into work, and they all have weaves and a whole different look, and basically she understands that if she wants to get ahead, she has to change her hair. What's so fun about this movie is that it's like the 80s, 90s nostalgia, and then on top of that, it has this B-movie horror vibe to it. Like, all the violence is so absurd and out of this world and silly, and it's just really well done. Yet again, I keep repeating myself, but I really liked it. Yeah, it's kooky, 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 kooky. So, the final thing I'll say on my little list here is that I really like Josephine Decker as a director. I don't think... I'm excited to see what she'll do next. I had seen... so eerie and has this kind of like sinister vibe.